Hi there. Thanks for joining me in another episode of PATINS TV. I am Kelli Suding, one of the 8 specialists with the PATINS Project. For the next few minutes, I am going to go over some valuable resources and strategies for students to engage with online text that will benefit them in multiple ways. As many schools are going one-to-one devices, students are reading online text visually and/or auditorily more than ever, and this way of accessing the text may be overwhelming for many students. I know that for me, I get overwhelmed when doing online researching and struggle with finding the relevant information that I need, especially if the article is really long. So it can be beneficial to our students by starting off with a simpler, summarized version of the article and also have a way to highlight the key points. This would be the same content, but condensed and easier to navigate and comprehend. And these supports can also be used as a way to pre-organize thoughts of the entire online content that needs to be read. And tools to help summarize and highlight is an approach that would be an accommodation versus a modification. Accommodation being accessing the same content as their peers by the use of a summarization or highlighting tool. So I want to show you some free online supports that may be used as you are trying to scaffold the idea of meaningful note-taking and recognizing key points of an article if your students do struggle with pulling out those key points themselves. So the first free online tool that I want to show you that's going to summarize an article and then we're going to work up toward more independent highlighting is called Summary. And this is what it looks like. It's just summary.com. And it's really simple. It looks just like this. So let's just say a student is doing a research on climate change. So I have this article from National Geographic, and you're gonna see that this article, if I keep scrolling, is gonna be really long, which can become really overwhelming for some of our students. And oftentimes when we're thinking about key points, what a student will do, which a lot of us do, is we just started looking up the first paragraph and just pulling out information from the first paragraph, and then we're missing a lot of the important information at the bottom. So with summary, all I have to do is copy the URL, open my summary, and it says paste the URL here, and that's what I'm going to do, and then I just click summarize. And once it pops up, and now I have 7-sentence summary of that entire article, and these are all of the key points of the climate change, which is going to make it a lot easier for students. So once we start identifying what the key points are, we want to scaffold this and start moving on to the next step, I would suggest using the Chrome extension called Auto Highlight. So it's basically going to do the same thing as summary, but look more like what students are typically used to when highlighting on printed text. So I have the Chrome extension up in my Chrome browser already, and all I have to do is hit highlight. So once I click highlight, some of the options on my article are going to be highlighted, and these are going to be the key points that were pulled from summary, but look a little bit different on using auto highlight. So this is the information. You can see all of the highlights that I have. And if my student feels like they want a little more information, I could click auto highlight again, and it may dig a little bit deeper and find some more information that that student may feel relevant. So visually, this is a lot easier to pull out that information. So now that my student understands the key points of an article, but when working toward that, and then they move to the highlighting tool, auto highlight, which is going to highlight them for them, they're ready for more of an independent way to highlight. And the Chrome extension called Super Simple Highlighter will do that just to fit those needs. And so what it will do is, if I'm scrolling through the same article and I feel like this is information that's relevant and it's a key point that I need for my research, all I have to do is highlight it. Right click, there's my super simple highlighter, and then I can choose whichever color that I would like. And one great thing about this is the highlights remain here on this website at all times until I clear them. And if I want to see the points that I've highlighted, I just have to open super simple highlighter, and there are my highlights. And one feature that I really like about this Chrome extension is that it gives the students auditory feedback.
It had taken a century of accumulating science.
So those notes are also going to improve comprehension skills by having that auditory feedback. And this is a really great way for students to access online text and be able to highlight to improve all of those skills that they need. So to wrap it up, having the ability to summarize articles and highlight online text can help students organize and identify key points, and more importantly, improve their comprehension of what they just read. This is an important skill for our students to acquire as they continue accessing online text. So thanks for watching this episode of PATINS TV. If you would like more information or support, please don't hesitate to contact us anytime. So thank you and bye for now.
Find us by searching PATINS Project on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube, or on the web at patinsproject.org.